Edgar Allan Poe's The Raven, you see, for distinctly, I remember it was in the bleak December. Once, upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered meek and weary over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, but I nodded nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping as of someone gently rapping at my chamber door. 'Tis a visitor I muttered, tapping at my chamber door, only this and nothing more. Presently my soul grew stronger, hesitating then no longer, sir, said I, O madam, truly your forgiveness I implore, but the fact is that I was rapping, and so gently you came rapping, and so faintly you came tapping at my chamber door, that I scarce was sure I heard you. But here I opened wide the door, darkness there, and nothing more. Back! Into the chamber turning, all my soul within me burning. Soon again I heard a tapping somewhat louder than before. Well, surely, said I, surely that is something at my window lattice. Let me see then what thereat is, and this mystery explore. Let my heart be still a moment, and this mystery explore. 'Tis the wind, and nothing more. Open here I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in this step a saintly raven of the stately days of yore. Not the least a day since made me, not a minute stop or stay he, but with mien of lord or lady perched above my chamber door, perched upon a bust of palace just above my chamber door, perched and sat, and nothing more. Though thy crest be shorn and shaven, and thou, I said, art sure no craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering from the nightly shore, tell me what thy lordly name is on the night's Plutonian shore. But quoth the raven, nevermore. But the raven, still beguiling all my fancy in the smiling, straight I wheeled the cushioned seat in front of bird and busted door. Then, upon the velvet sinking, I betook myself to linking fancy unto fancy, thinking what this ominous bird of yore, on this ghastly, grim, ungainly, not an ominous bird of yore, meant in croaking, nevermore. Prophet, said I, think of evil, prophet still, if bird or devil. By that heaven that bends above us, by that God we hope adore, tell this soul with sorrow laden, if within the distant Aden shall clasp a sainted maiden whom the angels name the door. Clasp a rare and radiant maiden whom the angels name the door. But quoth the raven, be that word a sign of poverty, murder, fiend, I speak of starving. Get thee back into the tempest and the night's Plutonian shore. Leave no black plume as a token of that line I so have spoken. Leave my loneliness unbroken. Quit the bust above my door. Take thy meat from out my heart, and take thy form from off my floor. But quoth the raven, nevermore. And the raven, never flitting, still is sitting, ladies and gentlemen, above a pallid mustard palace just above my chamber door. And his eyes, oh, his eyes have all the seemings of a demon's that is dreaming. And the lamplight over him streaming throws his shadow on the floor. And my soul, from out that shadow that lies floating on the floor, shall be lifted